Okay, so that was Frank Sullivan and Dirty Kitchen doing I Fell Short off their album On the Edge, which is one of my favorite modern bluegrass records. They're out of Washington, D.C. They're excellent on every instrument. But we started things off with the person who started bluegrass at the time bluegrass started, and that's Bill Monroe. He was looking for a specific sound. He formed the Bluegrass Boys, had a bunch of instrumentalists over the years, but it was when he had Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs on guitar and banjo respectively. That's what really started bluegrass music. That's the beginning. Everything that comes after is bluegrass music, and those guys are the ones that did it, and that's how they did it right there with the bluegrass breakdown. We're gonna have a lot more from them in the future, but I wanted to start things out with them. That's where I got the name for this playlist series, so I want to thank them. And then went right into another Bill Monroe written song called Jerusalem Ridge. But this is an interpretation by the incomparable John Stickley Trio. The fiddle player's name is Lindsay Pruitt. And she just totally takes what Bill wrote and just changes it around with John on the guitar and Patrick Armitage on drum set. And that's it. And they make great, great music with just three instruments. They're one of my most favorite bands, and I highly encourage everyone to go see them and find their show nearest you soon, because there's no experience like a John Stickley Trio show. John Stickley Trio is a band that not only do they write many amazing original songs, but they pay tribute to a lot of the bands that inspire them. And one of those guys is Tony Rice. I picked a song by him called Manzanita off his record Manzanita. It's an instrumental number that actually the John Stickley Trio does play and is on their EP called Triangular. But it's an amazing instrumental song that shows off a genre of progressive bluegrass started really by David Grisman, but adopted by Tony Rice at the same time. And that's one of those songs that is the cornerstone of everything progressive bluegrass to come afterwards. And it's one of my most favorite songs, and I had to include it on this list. After that, another great, great guitar player. We have a run of three really amazing acoustic guitar players here. And this one is named Molly Tuttle. She's the reigning IBMA Guitar Player of the Year. This is a song off her album Rise. It's an EP, seven songs. They're all really great. It's a song about the fact that you only need three friends, and she can have a band that tours and plays shows and supports herself. A friend and a friend and a friend. And then if she has those friends, she can go play shows because she's so talented. She's an amazing guitar player, she's an amazing banjo player, and she's an amazing singer. I can't wait to see what she does in the future, but for now, check out her album Rise. After that, I went old school with a song called Old Train. I went with the Seldom Scenes version of Old Train. There's a very famous Tony Rice version also off his album Manzanita. But this is the first version. This is where he learned the song. It's a song written by a guy named Herb Peterson, who's a Californian and historic in bluegrass in his own right out there. This is the Scenes version. They're from Washington, D.C. They're a legendary band. This is their original lineup with John Starling singing lead vocals. They've got John Duffy on the tenor part. And I love this song. I love the way they wrote it. I love the way Tony played it. And I love anybody who covers it. This is, if you're at a show and you play this song, I'm your fan. So I thank everybody that does that. After this, we ended with Frank Sullivan and Dirty Kitchen, so another great DC area band. Frank's lived in Alaska, he's got family in Hawaii, so he's got that influence, but he's a great guy, he's a great mandolin player, a great singer, he's got a great band around him. So they've got Chris Luquette, he's a great guitar player, Jeremy Middleton, he's a wonderful bass player, and then they've got the Maryland Monster. It's a name I came up with. It's kind of maybe stuck a little bit, I hope. for Mike Munford. He's an amazing, amazing banjo player out of the Baltimore area. He plays progressive music with the best of them, but he can also do all kinds of traditional music as well. He's well known in the bluegrass scene around here to the point where all the banjo players in the area go to him to have their setups done because he works on a banjo better than just about anybody. So I think it's great. I think Frank Sullivan Dirty Kitchen is a wonderful band, and I think that they're really a band that had to be included on this first playlist. I didn't really have a choice. I just think they're that good, and they deserve all the recognition they get. Another band that has to be on the list and it deserves every shred of recognition they get is a band called Driftwood out of Binghamton, New York. They're a band that's been touring for many, many years. They've got several albums. Their live show has an energy about it for four acoustic instruments. It's like you're at a rock concert in a way, but they have really great songwriting. They go from loud to soft very interestingly. If that's something you're able to appreciate, I hope you do. Up next is a song called Too Afraid off their most recent album, City Lights. And then after that, we've got some of the heavy hitters and jam progressive bluegrass, the Green Sky Bluegrass, Leftover Salmon, Infamous String Dusters, Strength in Numbers. We're just going on from here. So thanks for checking this out. Keep on listening. Let me know what you think in the comments and things like that. But for now, get ready to keep on rolling and rocking. Thanks a lot.